us direction from above. We need a word.
You got blessed. Oh, baby, come in me.
Just
say anybody that here been there, done that. Oh, they were okay with me when I was in the hoop thing and living in the hood. But God gave me a better car and a better house.
And give us peace.
Hello.
Apple.
Envy. And envy is not love. Love is kind. Kind people aren't envious. Say to your neighbor, Oh, neighbor, you don't have to envy me. The same God that blessed me can bless you. Amen. Give God a hand clap of praise up in here. Up in here, up in here. Kindness and love. Again, this text talks about what love is not, and kindness is defined as love. And point number two is, kind people aren't selfish. It says in verse 5, it is not rude, and it is not self-seeking. It is not self-seeking. So it's virtually impossible to be kind and selfish at the same time.
Help us,
Rev. Virtually impossible. Because kindness gets outside of self and looks and tries to meet the need of those around them that may have a need. But selfishness will never look outside itself.
Yeah, that's right.
Have you ever met those kind of people who were selfish? You've been talking to them for a whole hour and they didn't ask you nothing about you. Hello? Then ask one question, telling you what they have, boasting and bragging about what they have and what they do and all of that. And I like to tell single women, if you're on a date with a man that is not concerned about you or have asked you a question, then that person will not make a good mate.
Amen.
Because they don't have love. Because they are not kind. Kindness in the area of relationships, it's key. It's key. Many times, people think they can have love without kindness, and that's impossible. That's impossible. You will not experience love without kindness. Because if you have a selfish person and you marry them, then they bring all of their selfish needs into the household. And instead of paying the bills, they'll be selfish and buy a new car that they don't need. Instead of paying the bills, they'll be gambling. The bill money away. Instead of taking care of the household and paying the bills, they go out and buy new suits. Instead of being content with what they have, they go out and get them a new house that they can't afford, because it's all about them.
Yeah.
All
right.
And selfish people are not kind. They're not kind. Romans chapter 2 verse 8 says, but for those who are self-seeking and who reject the truth and follow evil, there will be wrath and anger. A person that has a selfish lifestyle won't have grace and mercy following after them. No, they will have what? Wrath and anger following after them. Hello? See, the man of God who hangs out in the household of the Lord, David says, surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the household of the Lord. But a self-seeking person will only have wrath and anger following them all the days of their life. And if you're a single woman, you definitely don't want to be involved in that. Kind people aren't selfish. Say to your neighbor, neighbor, don't be selfish. Say to your wife or your significant other, Be kind to me.
Be kind.
Yeah. Now don't get in trouble now. Don't get in trouble now. Again, we're talking about the kindness of love. This text talks about what love is not. We're talking about what kindness is not. And kindness isn't selfish.
That's right.
Point number three. Kind people aren't suckers. Which means, it says, and is not easily angered. Is not easily angered. There's an epidemic that's going on in our community and in our lives. Families are being destroyed. The basis of community life is the idea of family. A man, a woman, and children who follow after God.
Amen.
And our home life, our family life is being destroyed because we have a lot of women and men who don't have the ability to make the right kind of choices for love.
Mm. Wow. Amen.
I was looking at a movie yesterday entitled Their Eyes Were Watching God.
Yeah.
And it's a classic tale of a classic novel that was written, I believe, back in 1928. And this tells the story of a woman who was seeking love and three primary relationships that she had as a result of seeking love. One, she was married off to somebody, an older man, given away. And at 17, she ran and left the farm and fell in love with another man that went off to a town called Eatonville. Mm-hmm. If it was my town, it would be Etonville. About 20 miles outside of Orlando. And she got there and she married a very dignified man, but still she didn't feel like she had love. So she ran off after her husband died and gave her everything with a man by the name of T-Cake. And he said, they call me T-Cake because I'm so sweet. Grandmama used to make them tea cakes. Some of y'all don't know nothing about those tea cakes, but Grandmama used to make them tea cakes, and those tea cakes were real sweet. At least my grandmama did. That man was so sweet. He had that woman to leave her good house, her good town, and she was ended up in the Everglades in a hurricane, searching after love. She made a bad choice when it came to love. And that choice enabled her to lose almost everything. And at the very least, she was used. But our choice for me, is the number one indicator of whether or not your marriage relationship will be well or not. And we have women today who are attracted to men that they call thugs.
Wow.
Oh, yeah, they're in the thug love, the preacher said. Oh, and the women who are attracted to those thugs. Oh, they are attracted to the bad boys, some call them. They used to call them roughnecks. And all of those guys that they run after tend to be this way, and they tend to have this problem here, is that they are easily angered. They're easily angered. And before you know it, everywhere they go, they're in a fight.
Another calm on the sea. But what we need is a special word that will burn within our heart and give us direction from above.